The light coming through the curtains, the smell of coffee, the cold floor. I am hungry. It remains a strange sensation. Just one moment ago, this world didn't exist for me. I was without any experience. Then, in a split second, it was there. All these smells, sounds, movements, visual sensations. Consciousness refers to the bundled subjective experiences we all have. It is the continuously changing stream of experiences of the outside world and our body. Rain rattling on the roof, a rumbling stomach, the beautiful colours around us, a memory that pops up, the deadline that is ahead of us. In the 17th century, French philosopher René Descartes, like many scholars of that time, thought that we had a body and an immaterial and conscious soul. Based on animal brain research, he concluded that the soul could influence the body via the pineal gland, a small area deep in the brain. This dualistic idea remained influential until well into the 19th century. By that time, materialism slowly but surely replaced dualism. Scientists observed reliable functional relationships between certain brain areas and functions. And Charles Darwin made us realize that we are the result of a long evolutionary history, a history that we share partly with other animals, as can be seen in certain brain similarities. Thus, the brain, and not an immaterial soul, is responsible for our thoughts, perceptions, emotions, and behavior. Neurosurgeon Wilder Penfield saw some remarkable things in his epilepsy patients in the 1930s. When he stimulated them electrically in the brain during surgery, he sometimes evoked exceptionally vivid memories. Patients could feel, hear, and smell as if that memory was happening right now. Sigmund Freud argued more than a century ago that many of our mental processes take place unconsciously. In the 1960s, neuroscientists found interesting experimental evidence for this idea. Patients and animals with damage to visual parts of their brain did not perceive visual input consciously, but were still able to process visual information, a phenomenon called blind sight. With innovative brain imaging techniques, such as EEG and fMRI, combined with sophisticated analysis tools, brain research gained momentum in the 1990s. Neuroscientists could observe brain activity with millimeter precision on very fast timescales, and they could manipulate brain activity in a safe and controlled manner. UVA researchers and other scientists in the field have shown that it is not the activity in specific brain areas that is responsible for consciousness. Instead, the lightning-fast interactions between brain areas are crucial. The more complex these interactions, the fuller and richer our conscious experiences are. They've also confirmed in many ways, in patients as well as healthy participants, that a lot of information in our brain does not reach the surface of consciousness. These insights and technologies have recently been applied to patients with disorders of consciousness, such as coma or the vegetative state. In combination with clinical tests, brain imaging techniques are now used to improve the diagnosis and prognosis of patients with such disorders. For centuries, consciousness was considered to be a unique human feature. But with Darwin in the back of our minds, that idea becomes less and less likely. Animals most probably have conscious experiences as well. As their brains are less complex systems than ours, their experiences are probably less elaborate than ours. If consciousness results from dynamic interactions between parts of a system, could artificial systems, such as computers, also become conscious? If so, what would this mean for humanity? Trying to unravel the mysteries of consciousness in man, animal, and computer is one of the most profound and difficult quests for humanity. For progress, collaboration between experts from all academic fields, from neuroscience and AI to social sciences and philosophy, is crucial.